Can anyone help me find the blue area? No matter what, I cannot get the answer to number 7. I always get 16 over 3 plus e minus 1 over e. Let's take a look.
All right, let's see how we can find the area between these two curves. The first curve is this sine wave parabola given by the equation x equals y squared minus 2. And the other one is this sine wave exponential x equals e to the y. It's really just y equals ln x, but since the equation was written this way, so let's use that. So as we can see, this time we have a sine wave case. It will be easier if we use horizontal rectangles. So what I mean by that is, have a look. Let's draw a horizontal rectangle right here. This time though, the width is a little bit of y, so that's denoted by dy. And then we will have to look at the function on the right, which is e to the y. And that's, I'll just write it as x to the right, so xr. And then this right here is the function on the left. So that will be xl. So this is xr minus xl. That will be the length of, or the width, or however you want to say it, of the rectangle. So here we go, area equals integral, the function on the right is e to the y, minus the function on the left is that, which is just x, it's just y squared minus 2. But it has two terms, so make sure you put down parentheses. And we are in the y world, because we have the dy here, right? Then, be careful, we are in the y world, so pay attention to the y values. Y goes from negative 1 to positive 1. So negative 1 to positive 1. And now let's just go ahead and integrate this and we'll be done. Firstly, integrating e to the y is just going to be e to the y. And then minus integral of this is 1/3 y to the third power, reverse power rule. And then don't forget to distribute the negative. So that will actually give us a positive. Integrating 2 in the y world, we get 2y. And then let's go ahead and plug in the numbers. So plugging 1 first, we get e to the first minus 1/3, 1 to the third power, and then plus 2 times 1. And that's just the first part. And then minus plugging negative 1, we have e to the negative 1. And then minus 1/3, negative 1 to the third power, plus 2 times negative 1. This right here, let's just work out the exponents first. So this is going to be e, and then minus 1/3, and then plus 2. And then let's also distribute the negative. So we have minus e to the negative 1. And then be careful with this. Negative 1 to the third power is negative 1. And then negative 1, let me just highlight this for you guys. Negative times negative 1 is positive, but we have one more negative here, so altogether is negative. So this right here, so let me just indicate that. Altogether we have a negative here, and we have 1/3. And lastly, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. But again, we have to distribute this negative. So altogether, we have positive 2. All right? Yep. And then now let's just put things together. Perhaps let's do the fractions first. So we have this combined with that. And then that will be negative 2/3. And then 2 plus 2, which is 4, so plus 4. So that's the same as negative 2 over 3 plus 8. No, we need the denominator 3, so 12 over 3. So that will be positive 10 over 3. All right. And for the exponential power, just leave it like that. So we have e minus e to the negative 1. And lastly, plus 10 over 3. And that will do it.